Here with our GoJacks.com softball weekly update with head coach Krista Wood. Another good weekend for your program. Won two games out at Western Illinois. Start with game one, a big 11-run inning to really blow that game open and start the weekend off right.
Yeah, I mean, it was a tie ball game. I don't know, going into maybe the third or fourth, 2-2. And Allie Herliska and Brittany Morris had back-to-back jacks is what we call it. And then we just started rolling from there, and we just had the momentum, kept it on our side, and we were able to finish that game early.
Tried the clawback in game two, but you dropped that one 3-4. Just kind of take us through that game a little bit.
Yeah, after you have a big win like that, knocking their number one out of the game, you know, it's hard. It is hard to refocus, get back. And I mean, we hit the ball hard late in the game. We just couldn't get anything to drop. And we had to readjust to some different pitching, a little bit slower, a little bit lower than what the previous game was. We just didn't make adjustments quick enough, and then we did hit the ball hard, and it was right to people. We got two double plays that took us out of two big innings where we typically score in those innings, and it just didn't roll our way that game.
Rubber game on Sunday, two big innings in that game, once again, a 13-3 win and a series victory for your squad.
Yeah, and again, going into game three, we tell our kids adjustments, and it's about getting in there and swinging hard and being tough and staying mentally focused, because everybody's seen everybody's pitching, and it's going to be about who scores the most runs. And, you know, again, it was a close game going into like the third, or I mean, we were down early, and then we caught back up. I think we were down 3-0 or 3-1 early in the game, and we were able to scratch back to 3-3. And then after that, Julie Anderson came up with a huge bases loaded double that just broke it open for us. And that's what we need, is, you know, one person with bases loaded or running runners in, on second and third, that just breaks it open for us, that just gets our momentum going on our side, because we do swing hard, and we do put the ball in play hard, which I think is one of our one reason why we've been very successful on offense.
Obviously the best offense in the Summit League. Megan Rushing had a great weekend. She was named Summit League Player of the Week.
Yeah, Megan, I mean, had 10 RBIs this week and swung the bat really well. I mean, we had a handful of people swing really well at Western. I mean, Julia Anderson and Brittany Morris and Allie Herdliska and Abby Murphy, they were all swinging the bat hard and made great adjustments with what we prepared for, staying on plane, being on time. And I mean, they were huge keys into our two wins this weekend to win the series.
31 wins now on the season, 10-4 in the Summit League. It's been quite a turnaround for your program, and got to be just happy to keep it rolling here.
Yeah, I mean, it's been a fun season. Every single game's been on the road until tomorrow. So, I mean, our kids have been really, you know, mentally tough, in the fact that we haven't played home. We have been on the road for whatever games, 46 games straight. And, I mean, if you think about it, that's kind of crazy. And, you know, we want to play at home. We're excited to play at home. 10-4 in the Summit League, which is the best finish that they've ever had, and in Division I, 31 wins. And it's all a tribute to the hard work those kids put in, the extra time, the belief, and just the culture. The kids believe in each other. It's a fun team to coach, just because they all are in it for the same reason, and they're in it together. And that's the big thing that I've been preaching, is together we can be better, and together we can do big things.
You're in great position to be a top two seed in that Summit League tournament. 3-6 play on that Wednesday, so it'll be potentially a nice situation to be able to not have to play on a Wednesday of Summit League tournament.
Yeah, you know, there's one more weekend of Summit League play left, and we have that bye week. But I think we are in good position to be a 1 or 2 seed. It all depends on what happens this weekend. And it's huge going into Summit League tournament with a bye, because first round single elimination, anything happens really in the Summit League tournament. And then knowing that you don't have to play that play-in game, that's one less game our pitchers have to throw. And so that just, you know, we're already in double elim, and that gives us a day to practice up there, watch and prepare for who we're going to play.
Home opener tomorrow. It'll also be your last regular season games tomorrow against North Dakota. It'll be great to get on your home field for the first time, finally.
Yeah, we've had one practice on our field. Today will be two. And our first game, home game, will be tomorrow. We'll honor our seniors, our five seniors, and you know, we're looking, I mean, it's going to be tough games. I mean, North Dakota has two senior pitchers that have and kept them in all their games, and that's what they're good at is their pitching. So if we can score some runs on them, I think we'll be all right, and we just got to, you know, again, get something going in one of the innings. Usually the fourth, fifth, sixth innings when we start to get things going after we've made adjustments, seeing the pitchers a couple times. So we're excited to be at home. I know our kids are excited, our seniors are excited, and we're ready to be here and kind of show you guys what we have.
How excited are you for the players? I mean, that's got to be a special, you know, you've been on the road all year, and then to finally, you know, May 1st play your first home game.
Yeah, we just call it, you know, again, we said we're road warriors, so it's exciting. It's nice. It kind of gives you a little feeling of relaxation to be like, okay, we're at home. We don't have to worry about getting on a bus, catching a bus to get to the games. You know, we're familiar. We're hitting indoors where we hit, and we're ready to, you know, play on our home turf and defend it at home.
So turn the page to this weekend. You have the weekend off. What'll be the plans for that weekend?
You know, because we have the weekend or the week off, softball wise, we'll give our kids a couple days rest here just to get their finals in, finish strong academically, and then obviously Saturday is graduation, so our seniors will be honored there, and then we'll hit it hard. You know, Sunday, Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, practice up in Fargo on Wednesday, and get ready for the Summit League tournament if we do indeed have that bye.